Yeah, we are heroes tonight. town to town, from London to Taiwan. I've been all around the globe trying to protect your soul.
Sorry, I was finishing up dinner too. Just hungry. Hi. Okay, I can hear that. I don't have to hear myself talk. I should. Hi. Welcome back to my corner. After that long delay. Now we're back.
I got McDonald's with W. It's good.
I can... This computer still hasn't turned on. So I was like, fuck it, we're going live. Now, welcome back to Steve's Corner. We play my little corner of... It's my little corner of the network. Hi, hungry. Are you still hosting the corner? I took a week break last week because the other camera died. Funnily enough, after the last Steve Corner, I don't know what happened, but we're using the webcam, which I think actually looks pretty good. But other than that, we got a drink to try. It's in the been in the fridge for 2 weeks. So that's still good. Coca-Cola spiced. With a little crisp. It smells good. Oh, that's very raspberry. Oh, that's making a mess. Okay. May have been a mistake. So we'll just, Could be. Raspberry Spice Coke with other natural flavors. I'm just going to click this forward so that way there's no other thing. Alright, let's give it a try. The bubbles have stopped. This ain't it. This really ain't it. This is not good. In the slightest. It's like... Tastes like perfume. Like a heavily raspberry perfume. I waited 2 weeks for this. What bullshit. I want my money back. Anyway, games. We have a game. Gran Turismo 2. One of my favorite games. I forgot where we left off. It's been so damn long. A license. They've not hit a single good Coca-Cola. Just listening to make sure audio is balanced good. It's fine. But yeah, like Coke 2000, 3000, whatever it wasn't great. The marshmallow Coke was not good. Like I didn't say this, there's a lot of bubbles in it. That is not a good thing. Balance is good, thank you, Dave. Where can I go next? Okay, that. Oh yeah, I ran this like super in a station wagon race. I can't hear the game. That should help. Let's move on with the license tests. I feel like that's a good jumping off point. I'll have to try the zero sugar version next week. Maybe that's better. I don't know. Yep, there it is. Was not paying attention. Well, I wasn't paying attention to what I had to do. I don't know. It's like, it's aromatic, and that's the problem. Oh, God, that was almost perfect. Take a sober. I'm just thinking maybe the, maybe the not real sugar can, like, balance it well. Break on a turn. What a stupid. Whatever. This Subaru Legacy is pretty nice, though. Take the bronze and go. That was a shitty challenge. This one better be a not stopping one. Oh, thank goodness. Dave, have you tried the new McDonald's sauce yet? Or the WickDonald's sauce, whatever it's called now. The sweet chili. And if so, what are your thoughts? Yep, I've tried it. It's very... It reminds me of a sauce, like a kind of It's spicy. That's like the biggest, my biggest thing with it is it is very, it's a bit spicy. It just reminds me of something else. I can't remember exactly what it was. But yeah, definitely give it a try. It's very, if you didn't know it was a promo, it would definitely taste like a very Asian-oriented sauce. I like it. It's kind of like the style of all the sauces there, if you get what I mean. It's got great flavor. Oh, that was a great turn. That's gonna be a bronze, but that was a great turn. That's a silver. God damn. What are we at for time right now? 21 minutes. So this laptop has been chugging along for 21 minutes. It is the consistency of a jelly. It's that, but like very liquidy, like a jelly that you'd get in like a squeeze bottle. Like I was able to pour some on my quarter pounder with cheese. With no issue. 26-3. It's pretty good. God, a Supra. How stupid the Supra kind of looks if you look at it in weird angles. Trip turn. One of those at Target the other night. I think that's a 3000 GT. Yeah, actually one like this. It was fucking sweet. The 3000 GT is such an underrated car. Better than the Supra. Said bad about the Supra, I'm gonna fail the challenge. Oh, yeah.
Good.
This would be a good mixed drink with, like, Jack Daniels or something. Alright. Now that's done. The fun thing of saving and then moving to the other disc. I wonder if that 1-900 number is still in service. Siri, are 1-900 numbers still a thing?
Okay, I found this on the web for our 1-900 number still a thing. Check it out.
Huh. Oh, well, that's loading up. We'll learn a little bit. They peaked in 1992, paid $3 billion for their services. Alright, we'll go up below. I'll cam view this. Telecom analyst Roger Entner said that the cases were in which kids would call these numbers and rack up hundreds of dollars on their parents' phone bills led to increased regulation. They ruled against 1-900 numbers for that provided adult services, killing businesses in that space. The FTC created a rule in 93 that made companies disclose the cost at the beginning of the call. In the one of the final major blows to the industry, the AT&T announced in 2002 that it would no longer provide billing and collection services for 1-900 numbers. By 2012, Verizon had become the last carrier that supported 900 numbers. Huh. That's cool. So I can't call a 1-900 number. Oh well. Back to the game. Learn something new every day. Yeah, more tracks. Oh, that's right, my Blue Skyline. Red Rock Valley. Yeah, because they won't be able to charge... Well, that's a good thing that's gone. Now you got gets rid of a lot of those scammers. I'll never forget the one time I was myself and my grandma went over to my great uncle's house. And he asked for help. It was like at least 10 years ago now. He asked for help with his golf game for his old computer. Oh no, it wasn't the phone number. It was, he tried to go to the website for it. So like, he asked for help with it. He was like, oh hey, can I check the site to see any tips? He was like, yeah, go for it. And we did. And it turned out to be a porn site. Or like, it redirected to a porn site. I was like, mother, god dang it. Or that video, the Angry Video Gamer calling the number from Who Framed Roger Rabbit, the game. And that turned out to be an adult hotline. Which is really funny. But hey, Red Rock Speedway. This track is awesome. I wish it would come back. It's a weird ass old. Computer is still going. It's past 8 o'clock. It's cleaning up, it says. I call it bullshit. I turn it on, I want to say at least like 4 hours ago. Just to be like. Oh no, it was plugged in and turned on by itself. Or I plugged it in and turned on by itself. They start beeping at me. I was like, well, oh well. Just kind of waited on it until I got back in. Fuck. We're good. I think that's the Tommy Kyra in second. No, it looks like a Corvette. Someone's very close. Do the Corvette in second. Getting challenged with that. That looks like the Tommy Kyra. Just a second. There we go. Oh, that poor laptop just wants a nap. It naps all week. It needs to waken. It needs to clean up. It's still cleaning up. It's been cleaning up. Call it, it was a Tommy Kyra. Only we could put it out of its misery. What the fuck does it taste like? This tastes like something. I got nothing. Tastes like stupidity, that's what it tastes like. The next track. Seattle. I love Seattle Circuit. One of my favorite tracks in the game. Actually, one of my favorite tracks on Gran Turismo. That hasn't come back since Gran Turismo 4. Such a fun track to race. Well, you could play it if you have the Gran Turismo 5 Master mod and the Gran Turismo 6 Spec 2 mod. That is a lot of effort to go through.
At least for the GT5 Mastermind, you have to be on like a specific firmware of the game, or else it just won't work. Gran Turismo 6 can be on like the most, you have to be on the most recent firmware. However, to get to the most recent firmware is a pain in the dick because you have to download it and you have to have it installed in game, and if you do it all at once, it will take literally like several. When I say several, I mean like 5, 6, 7, 8 hours to install. So you have to install the game in chunks. All that. That Mazda's right there. I need to like just keep focusing. Back straight away. Hard right-hander. The chicane. Or the bus stop, sorry. I guess it's the other. Whoa! Oh god, the Corvette's right there. It's a very Corvette-centric track. Well, yeah, jumping back, once you get all the mods installed, it's definitely worth it, because the GT5 Master Mod has literally all the cars and a bunch of the cut tracks that were in GTPSP. Ported over. And some cut cars too. That's the only way you can race the Joey Logano GameStop car. Because you had to pre-order the game from GameStop. And you get like a code for it. Or you have to get very lucky on like, if you choose Toyota and for your as your favorite manufacturer and for your birthday, you get one random Toyota a year for free. You can get the Joey Logano GameStop 20 car, which is a pretty nice car. I'm impartial to the red cars. Because that was just an interesting footnote in NASCAR history. That could come back with Shane Van Gisbergen. Shit. Oh, he's there. Perfect Corvette's there. We're good. We're clear. It's racing through its weakness. Not straight lines. Ooh, that monster gets by him for a second. It's a drag race. Oh. Side by side, almost three wide for a second. It's not going to be enough. We take the dub. It was three wide. Jesus Christ. Corvette lost it. I'm gonna give the rest to Nicole when I get home. See how she likes it. That sounded kind of frightening. It's not what I meant. Green Forest? I don't think I've heard of that track. God damn it. Okay.
What's that track in that? Gran Turismo 3.
This looks like the precursor to it.
I could see the logo on it. I might have to look it up while it's loading. Alright, here we go. Gran Turismo 3. Tesla Model 3. Oh, that's Gran Turismo 7. Not gonna lose the race because I'm right looking up something. It is. Swiss Alps, okay. I saw it, the logo was blue. That's all I remember from it. That track was good. We gotta get by the Elise quick. Inside of the Forester. Here we go. I didn't even see who was in the race again, so that's a slight problem. I see the Tommy Kyre, or the Lotus Elise. That's it. Help, go. The Mazda's there, we are side by side coming to the right-hander. We're gonna have the advantage. Contact with the Lancer. Falling back. Cross over the Lancer. Clear. The long back straight. If I could punt him, I would. Just leaving me in the dust. Light push, slide. It turned on. Oh. That time is incorrect. I'll fix it later. Using the wall to catch him. He's got a poke nose. Get a nose on him in this corner. Broke early. Cross me over, that motherfucker. The wall to help. Go. We're here. We're there. No. I'm gonna lose it. Oh, I got through there very well. Didn't get through that very well. Gonna have to send it. Ross Chastain it. Worth a try.
Take a second while I fix this. My chat. There we go. Push the Elise to the front. It's alive. Thank you, Dave. Thank you for the alert, and thank you for hanging out. It's much appreciated. That's not ready for it this time. Cha-cha slide on the Mitsubishi. This turn. What a move! I'm gonna have to watch it again on my phone. Before I get this up going. Was quite the cha-cha slide. It's loading. It's loading. It's not responding. Whatever. 826. Cool. All the bonus items so far. That means we unlocked new class escorts. Oof, CTR 2. Class editors. B. Hatsu. Alright, let's get things done here for now. Let's save here. Move back to the other disc and crush some more races. Clean off my case. Kind of gross. Dual analog controllers. DualShock analog controllers. The imitators are shaking in their pleather boots. Okay. I'll add this on the back of this disc. Gran Turismo 2, the album, Music at the Speed of Sound, featuring bands like Rob Zombie and Fear Factory, and Gary Numan, Moby, Filter, Gear Whore, Soul Coughing, and many, many more. Fuck, Dragula's in this game? I believe that's like one of the credits songs. This is user manual. What the fuck are you? Reference manual. The fuck is this reference manual for? Techniques. Let's go race. We'll take my motherfucker. No. Yep. Fuck. Special event. Yeah. Super Speedway, one of my favorite tracks. Because it's an oval. based off of the Twin Ring Motegi, which was built specifically in Japan to attract the growing NASCAR group. For the growing NASCAR fandom, I should say. At least back in the 90s, NASCAR was huge in Japan. Well, they drove three races there. Cups. They didn't count for shit, but they did. Even though we did lose the life of Colonel Langley, who was the pace car driver in the late 80s, early 90s. I believe the first time they went out to Japan? Could be wrong. Is the best average during the NASCAR Japan races. We'll have to look. It might be Jeff Gordon. But I know we finished second, I think twice. He finished second in 98 at the Motegi. Or 99, okay. Or 98, if I'm okay. Damn it. NASCAR in Japan. Jeff Gordon finished second in the 90s. That's Wendell Jr. What about 1997? Mike Skinner won in 97. Nope, Jeff Gordon did not finish second in the Thunder Special. Care about the terms of services. I was so confused for a second because I clicked it wrong. It had fucking Michael Waltrip in second with a transmission issue. Or third with transmission issue. I was like, I don't think that's how that works. So third. many goddamn exhibition races. iRacing, I forgot about that. Nikon Indy 300. Oh, it's IndyCar. Oh my god, why didn't I... Never mind. Ooh, this is an 80 sports car. Jeff Gordon didn't even run the second year. Ricky Craven ran that car. Okay. Eh, the more you know. Alright, let's figure something out. We'll go to West City. This car I'd like to get. Or I'd like to... Fuck. Let's go to South City. I guess it makes sense. This will be good for the FF races. What I want to do is I want to take this fucking car and do this. And Dave, if you're still lurking, check this shit out. $82,000 is not bad. So we're gonna get, that's the goal. I just spent $32,000 on this car, so we gotta make it count. Started. Ugh. Don't get old, people. Oh god, we got this. An old friend of mine had a car almost exactly like this. Oh shit. Except this was a few model years ago. Kind of a piece of shit. He had the flex tape of war shovel and died on it. like after the finale of this game, I will we're gonna test out the Gran Turismo 2 A-Spec GT2 A-Spec mod for a stream. Citroen Saxon. Oh shit, got a new car for that. Let's go. Yeah, that has to be that. Okay. That one will come in handy. I don't think these two will. To the Ford department tuner up. Some basic things, nothing too fancy. Throw some sport tires on it. Weight reduction. transmission. Just so that way I can just not be fucked. You're supposed to have it. Clutch doesn't matter. Drive shaft doesn't matter because I can't buy it. Alright, I think I'm ready to go back into it. Shit. Don't have either of these, so that's fine. Let's go race. Challenge. 345 is recommended. I'm at like 280, 250. Let's go. Oh god, that car actually sounds a lot better. Not right off the line, yeah. Oop. Looks like the Camaro of this era. Which I saw one. Yes. That was today on my way in. It was actually really nice. The, like, 90s Camaros are underrated as all for one. If I were to get a Camaro, it would definitely be one. We are almost side by side. We were almost side by side in the Civic. Just the blurs in the back. I didn't have my race, but that made me really close. Yeah, I give me the push. lock my ass off. Here we go. On the final straightaway, it doesn't matter. I have the higher top speed. Specific type R's. Jesus. $6,000, not bad. And another car. Let's see if this new car is. We'll probably call it a night. Ah, shit! That's actually kind of nice. An FF. Not bad, not great, not what I need. I'm curious about this. See if I can tear this up. Rome or Seattle short. Track that has never come back in a Gran Turismo game, and it's very sad. Well, I might be fucked. Dog shit. Attention. I think I won this for winning the first station wagon race. I don't remember. hate that thing. Coming together up here, it's like, hey, let's play. Better than the alternative. I got the alternative as well. Dave could attest to it. I got the old story. See the fucking carousel. Sheesh. And a new car. Okay. That's even better. Actually, while I'm getting to the new car, take off the headset and just vibe for a sec. Sorry. Tired. Very tired. Legacy Wagon GTBJ. 74. Which is this guy? Ah, this one's better. Why would I drive that? Man, I could drive this, the other fucking one. That was pretty nice. Anyway. Work our way to the save function. As we do. Once again, everyone, thank you so much for tuning into my corner. My corner. We should be back next week with some more GT2. Play more games. More of game, I should say. Excuse me. Yeah. We'll be back next week. More racing, more fun. Yeah. Saving complete, so that means the stream's complete. Be sure to tune in to WWB and Lily's News on Friday. WWB going live when I get it done. And Lily's News going live at 5. Lot to talk about this week. New bill passed this morning. But that's not my forte. Definitely check that out on Friday. So I have a feeling that's going to definitely be a big topic. Falls Count Anywhere Monday. Possibly Wetro tomorrow. I'm going to bug Mike about it. Falls Count Anywhere Monday. Getting back to some more WWB Gauntlet this week. Yeah. Changes coming to the network. Be sure to keep it tuned in. We'll see you next time. Adios, everybody.